A good approach and landing requires accurate flying by understanding the relationship between pitch and power, the aiming point versus the touchdown point, how to perform a roundout and flare, and following through with the touchdown and landing roll. Regarding pitch and power, pitch is always adjusted to keep flying at the aiming point, and power is adjusted for a desired airspeed. Pitch and power work together, so if you change one, you must change the other in order to hold airspeed constant. This is called the point and power technique, and it will give you a constant glide path to the runway, also called a stabilized approach. On final, we fly at approach airspeed towards the aiming point by adjusting pitch and power. This aiming point is where the plane crashes if you don't round out and flare. The round out and flare slows down your airspeed and descent rate to achieve a soft landing, requiring a certain distance depending on your approach airspeed. When you're slow enough and in a landing attitude, you will land on the touchdown point. If your airspeed or descent rate is too fast though, you will bounce off the runway at the touchdown point. Here are the three main phases on final. On descent, we're using the point and power technique to fly at our aiming point. During the roundout, we level the plane off close to the ground to slow down the airspeed and descent rate. And during the flare, we bring the airplane into a landing attitude to further reduce airspeed and descent rate for a soft touchdown. To demonstrate the aiming point, I'm using the same one as in the earlier picture, so I'm aiming at the runway numbers. So using the point and power technique, I'm using pitch to point the airplane at the aiming point, and then I'm adjusting the power for our desired airspeed. If you do this correctly, the aiming point will stay in the same position on the windscreen during your approach. Now as we come in, I'm not going to round out or flare, so I strike the runway at the aiming point, and we'll ricochet off because we still have a very high airspeed and descent rate. Right. So here you'll see an external, I'm still on the descent attitude, and this causes a high airspeed and high descent rate, so when I hit the aiming point, I'll bounce off the runway. Now we'll look at the relationship of pitch and power on an approach. If I zoom in, we can see my aiming point is not at the runway, but in fact it's actually at the road in front of the runway. So right now the airplane is flying towards that road, which means my aiming point is underneath where it needs to be. And this will lead to me flying a much lower approach that requires a correction. I do this by raising the nose. This brings the aiming point back up towards the runway. But by raising the nose, I'm going to lose airspeed, so I need to increase power to compensate for that. Now that I'm fixing the lower approach by putting my aiming point at the end of the runway, this will let me get back onto the correct glide path. So right now, if I zoom in, my aiming point is actually at the far end of the runway. And if I hold this, I'm going to have too high an approach. So I lower the nose and fly the plane back towards the original aiming point of the numbers, and then I'm adjusting the power to reach my desired airspeed. So if I'm lowering the nose to get to the aiming point, I'm going to reduce the power, and this will let me hold the airspeed. But if I have to raise the nose a little bit, I'm going to add some power. The smaller the adjustments you make on final approach, the more stable your approach will be. Now we'll look at another landing with a fully stable approach with the round out and the flare. Again, I'm going to use the same aiming point of the numbers at the beginning of the runway, and this should stay in the same spot on the windscreen as I'm making my approach. So I'm adjusting my pitch very slightly in order to keep that aiming point in the same spot, and then I have to adjust my power to maintain the same airspeed. Like I've said before, the goal is to make these approaches as stable as possible. So the smaller the adjustments you can make, the better. Because if you don't notice the changes, then as you get closer to the runway, it's going to require more drastic inputs in pitch and power. Now unlike the previous example, I'm not going to strike the aiming point, but instead I'm going to do the roundout and then the flare. So as we get closer to the ground, we're still flying to the aiming point. But before we hit it, we round out by leveling the plane off and slowly begin raising the nose for the flare without climbing, so you can reach the proper landing attitude at the touchdown point without bouncing. After touchdown, it's important to maintain directional control on the center line, so we hold full back pressure and then begin applying the brakes and using the rudder as required to maintain center line. Don't apply full brakes on touchdown. Instead, apply them gently, and then as the plane slows down more, you can progressively add more and more brakes to help you come to a full stop. Now we'll look at the last part of this approach in the external view. Again, we're flying to the aiming point in the descent attitude. Then at the aiming point, set the powder idle and level off. As the plane slows, raise the nose to flare and reduce the descent rate without climbing to land on the touchdown point. Then maintain your center line using the rudder and the brakes, and then eventually come to a full stop.